Hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder upcoming content video. We didn't just get a new Battle Pass vehicle dev blog today, but we also got a new ship or vessel to take a look at. This is the USS Mitscher. It's the DL-2 and is getting, well, at least when the dev server was up, this vehicle was getting some talks and some conversations going. I'm not quite sure why. I don't think I picked up on exactly what was interesting about the vessel other than that it looks pretty badass. But let's read on and see what it's up. So it is the first U.S. destroyer of the Cold War era featuring auto-loading 127mm guns. Okay, maybe that has something to do with it. It's USS Mitscher. It's a DL-2. It's a destroyer for the United States of rank 2. Features are that it has an automatic main caliber cannons, excellent mobility, large complement, but it only has two main caliber guns. So, awesome. There's some interesting history on the unit if you are interested. Okay, and then we've got some screenshots of the vehicle. So we've got some secondary weapons or auxiliary weapons, and then there is also these launchers, of which there is, I believe these are rocket launchers, of which there are two separate ones, which I'm curious to see. It looks like a baby U.S. heavy cruiser. You know how U.S. heavy cruisers of the time had a very specific design to them, even of different classes, they all shared a similar style? This kind of looks like that to me. It's got the two giant funnels in the center, and it's, I don't know, it just looks and feels like this is a baby cruiser. But let's go ahead and take a look at the other screen shit here, which is the anus of the ship. Definitely looks pretty snazzy. It's a post-World War II vehicle. In War Thunder, the USS Penis will be a new destroyer arriving in the mid-ranks of the American Naval Forces tree with the release of the upcoming major update, expanding the American destroyer lineup into the Cold War era. This ship brings with it several distinct new features not necessarily found on older designs, and in today's devlog you'll find out all about it. Let's get started. So this ship's primary armament consists of two single 5-inch or 127mm cannons, being a staple primary gun caliber found on most World War II era U.S. destroyers. What the hell, my I just died for a second there. Some captains may initially become concerned at the number of guns fitted on the ship, however, looks can be deceiving, and that's certainly the case with this warship. Despite only possessing two primary guns, the ship's 5-inch cannons are equipped with an automatic loading mechanism, giving it a mind-boggling fire rate of 40 rounds a minute. Okay, as a result of the two cannons' combined fire rate can certainly replace a much larger conventional gun battery in terms of volume of fire, and captains should have no problem wreaking total havoc on their opponents. However, the ship's arsenal doesn't end just there. In addition to the 5-inch guns, the warship comes fitted with a pair of twin 3-inch rapid-firing long-range anti-aircraft cannons, as well as four twin 20mm automatic cannons for short-range AA duties. Rounding off the ship's weapons complement are four 533mm torpedo launchers, depth charges, as well as the Weapon Alpha anti-submarine rocket launcher, which some captains may be familiar with from commandeering the Japanese Isuzu frigate. In addition to the ship's excellent firepower, the ship also boasts a much larger crew complement than any other American destroyer currently in the game, consisting of 350 sailors. As a result, the USS Penis can better deal with combat damage than other destroyers, having more crew available to conduct repairs and extinguish fires. However, being a destroyer also means that the ship doesn't possess any protection. As a result, the ship remains vulnerable to high-caliber fire, and larger warships are better dealt with by outmaneuvering them with the ship's excellent mobility and subsequently launching torpedoes from a distance. Here we've got some screenshots and a side shot. It's a very nice-looking vessel. There's a semi-butt-cheek shot. And then a boob side shot, or side boob. So it'll be coming in the next major update, groundbreaking, to rank 2 in the United States Bluewater Fleet tech tree. Alright, and you can of course buy the Helena or Helena pack to boost your research. So that is that. Kind of exciting to see a new destroyer, and a more unique looking destroyer as well for the United States tech tree. The guns definitely sound interesting to me. The fast fire rate, I'm very curious to see how that's going to work out. If you haven't been paying attention to the news, here is what else they have announced for the next major update thus far, officially on the website. We are getting the Chinese ZTL-11 wheeled tank destroyer for ground forces. Germany is getting three variants of the Weasel, including one with an automatic cannon, one with SAMs, and one with an ATGM launcher, a TOW. The Italians are getting the VCC 8030, which is basically a modified Dardo. excuse me, I'm out of breath. For naval forces, the Italians are getting the Tiger destroyer as a new premium for their tech tree. The British are getting the HMS Marlborough for their tech tree. And also, of course, the most recent United States aircraft, or excuse me, ship. For aviation, they have only shown off the Chinese V-12D that's coming to their tech tree, as well as, of course, the announcement of the Israeli aviation tech tree that's coming with two planes, a Spitfire and a Skyhawk, that are going to be available for pre-order, or basically not necessarily pre-order, but you'll be able to buy them when the update releases, which will gain you access to the CBT for the Israeli tech tree. There is also the Battle Pass that has been started to be shown off, and in that we're getting the PT-658 patrol boat and the French LVT-440, which is an LVT with a 40mm Bofors gun on it. And then lastly, there is the new maps and features. There will be three new maps in the next major update, one for ground forces, one for air arcade, and one for naval forces. And of course, the groundbreaking effects, which allows you to actually deform the terrain using dozer blades, dig up the terrain, etc. It's going to be pretty interesting to see. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Goodbye.